Hi peeps, and welcome back to another Master Waterman tutorial slash vlog. Yeah, I'm getting in at a spot on the KZN North Coast. It's quite a bit of shore break, South Africa. Trick with carbons is normally to get in shore break, past, and put carbons on. But Fat Boy here has a problem with putting his fins on in the water to get a bit of a cramp. So I put my fins on first on the beach, and then walk down sideways so shore break does not wash up and over the fins, bend them and break them. Get to stage critical, flip over, flop down, slide down the beach, and then through the shore dump. Very dark and gloomy morning, late February. Oh, there's Viz. A little bit of river water mixed in. And out past the back line. The bait on the bottom. Perfect Viz for snook and game fish. Take my 130, 214 mils. Bam, clip it on my belt. Pull the float up to get to my Rob Allen deployable flasher. To always clip to the float line first. The loop. Please note a certain distance from the float, that my fish are kept close while I'm busy with the flasher, all fad. The Rob Allen flashers now have a tie that holds the lid on, which is a great thing. Now I've already got myself into a fish, a lovely springer, about 6 kilos. Fortunately, the camera was off when I took the shot. I'm busy chasing the fish on the float line. Just remember what's key here. Dark and gloomy and raining. Opposite river mouth. You'll see why these are key factors a bit later in the video. So this ladyfish can pull. Is springer. A lot of people say that they're not good eating. They make damn fine fish cakes. They have a lot of very fine bones in them. So best to put them through the mincer and make fish cakes. Because the North Coast is quite a big springer. Saw the bait fish darting off there. Pretty good holding shot. The fish has basically swam itself to death, so it will be an easy land. It'd be awesome to get one that size on a fly rod. My biggest to date on fly rod is only about 3.5 kilos. Awesome colors. And then just after, 3 queen mackerel, the toss nook, pulled into my flasher. I managed to actually spine both the fish, get a double up. And again, camera off, but at least we can see the aftermath. Please take note, gloomy, raining, opposite a river mouth. String the first fish. And a quick reload. Pull up the second snook. Not much fight in either of them due to spining them. Spining is when your spear breaks the spine of the fish and immobilizes it. Doubling up and spining one fish. It's quite a rarity. When you're good, eh? pretty full of myself at this stage. Two lovely snook on. And a springer. My dive mate, Paul, hasn't seen a fish yet. And why are these fish hanging around here? Let's have a look-see. Busy reloading and a little bait ball of anchovies. Just take notes, every time I look back you can see my fish perfectly fine sitting just behind me, but just a little bit too far away. I'm not holding my flasher. Now some mozzies pull in, another type of bait fish. Why are they sitting right on me the whole time? You can see they're just swimming past my mask as the anchovies. So what's happening is the anchovies are actually using me as cover to get away from the circling eastern little tuna, which you can see on the outside every now and then, and the mozzies. And the mozzies and the eastern little tuna, by the way, are excellent bait fish for live bait on the KZN North Coast and the South Coast. He's like, nope, my fish behind me, fine, not a problem. Thought I'd do some National Geographic filming. And be one with the bait ball. So those mozzies, little yellow fishies, are trying to get at the anchovies, which are using me as cover. I mean, I could just grab one of those at any stage. That's how close they are. So yeah, bait is key when you're looking for game fish. See the anchovies on the top there. The mozzies trying to go for them. Queen mackerel, springer, and rock cods, they just love those anchovies. And will hang around a bait wall. They're a lot easier to shoot. There don't seem to be any snook around these guys. Those anchovies are using me as cover. Please note my fish behind me is still fine. Now look how these anchovies are actually using me for cover here. They are sitting on my back. And watch the mozzie is trying to eat them off my back. You can see one or two anchovies flipping around on my back there. There's one lying there on my shoulder. How's that for being one with the bait ball? Our bait balls on the KZN North Coast tend to attack some action. Like, sometimes maybe the wrong kind of action. Saw my fish by me there, still fine, but I'm not holding where I normally hold, which is on my flasher there. My fish are a bit too far behind me. Normally I keep them closer. Fish is still fine. Oh no, oh no. Felt a little pluck on the float line. Have a tug, so make to have a look. One bite. Half a 6 kilo snook. Gone. Taxman. Now where's the shark? Couldn't spot him in the mixed in river water and keen water. Bloody bastard. Wind picking up. Snook moved off. My dive mate pulled a shot. Didn't know about the shark. Just keep your head watching my fish. Which he didn't do. He swam off into the current. Or slow poke, I couldn't keep up. And then, on the deeper reef, there's the culprit. Wouldn't come in close enough so I could give him a poke and chase him. We argued it later as a sandbar shark. Probably about 70, 80 kilograms. So yeah, if it's dark and overcast and you're diving in a little bit of river water near a river mouth, there are going to be sharks around. Keep your eyes peeled, keep your fish close to your fins. Pesky bugger, I couldn't even get down to get bottom fish reefed up. You can see I put my gun on the float. My second gun, which tends to keep the sharks away from the float. And as always, dive safe and straight spears from the bear.